If you look at a map of the United States of America, you'll notice a couple of states that are boring rectangles. It seems the shape of Wyoming and Colorado are the most boring in the Union. But what if we take a closer look at one of these? Is, for example, the shape of Colorado as boring as it first appears? Well, the borders of most other states were defined by geographic features, such as rivers and mountains. The borders of Colorado were defined by the 36th Congress in 1876 when establishing the new territory of Colorado as being between 37 and 41 degrees north of the equator and 25 and 32 degrees west from Washington DC, because measuring the prime meridian from Greenwich was just a little too British for the Americans. Although, to be fair, we had not yet had the 1884 International Meridian Conference selecting Greenwich as the international standard. So far, everything looks rather like a rectangle, the great state of Colorado being defined by straight lines running north-south and east-west. However, while the lines of latitude are parallel, the lines of longitude, when overlaid onto a spherical Earth, converge as you reach the poles. The shape of Colorado, therefore, is some kind of weird trapezoid, with two subtly curved sides and on a curved surface. The northern border, being closer to the North Pole, is therefore shorter than the southern border, by about 21.2 miles. However, while nice-looking lines on maps are great, on the ground, we need to know exactly what bits of desert are in Colorado and what bits are in Utah. So in 1879, a team of surveyors began at what is now the Four Corners Monument, the only point in the United States where four states meet, and travelled northwards, marking the border at 1 mile increments as they travelled. Despite being equipped with the latest 19th century surveying technology, including the compass, the chronometer, and the theodite, and giving the task their best effort, their measurements and calculations were slightly off, and they arrived about 1 mile west of where they expected. Later surveys in 1885 and 1893 discovered the sites of minor errors. The largest, near the ominously named town of Paradox, Colorado, shows the survey team drifted west by more than a mile across an 8 mile stretch. Similar errors exist all along the border too, and are evident in the borders of other states with similar straight line borders, such as Wyoming. But it was all too late. The border had been marked and everyone had agreed that that was the border. And changing it would now require the agreement of both state legislates and Congress. It simply wasn't going to happen. Colorado's shape would be forever a polygon with hundreds of sides that approximates a rectangle and is possibly the most interesting shape a state could be. But let me know what you think in the comments below. And speaking of interesting, I actually heard of this topic in an episode of HFS, the science podcast that's not for kids, from the people over at SciShow. I'll leave a link to the show in the description below. And it's appropriate that this particular video was inspired by a topic covered by Hank Green on the podcast, as this video is brought to you with the support of the Vlogbrothers. And so a huge thank you to Hank and John Green for their support, and to all those who support the channel.